Hey everyone, and welcome to Explore HQ. Today I'm gonna be doing a wiring installation of a couple more lights that I bought. Before we get to that though, I want to kind of catch you up on how I got to this point. A few weeks ago, I did some testing on some Amazon LEDs to replace the fog lamps that were in my aftermarket bumper. Made a decision on those, got what I wanted installed, returned the rest. Upon returning the rest, one of the companies I bought from sent me a coupon and a link to check out another set of lights, and ultimately took the coupon, wanted to check them out anyway, kind of looked neat, nothing like I'd really seen before, so definitely wanted to check them out. And then I started thinking as they were coming, where the heck am I going to put these? And the only other place I have to install lights is on my roof rack. And actually getting higher off the ground to aim some lights down would really help with when you're off-roading. Tiny little bitty holes all of a sudden looking like craters if you don't have appropriate lighting. So that snowballed, went down another wormhole, and then kept digging from there. But I wanted to show you the lights that I end up getting. In fact, after testing them, liked them so much, I actually bought two sets. So I have four lights that I'm actually going to be installing on my roof rack today. So, without further ado, here they are. These guys are a flood. They did not have a lumen projection put it out. If I had to guess, each one of these lights probably puts out about 6,000 lumens. And I know that's just from testing all the other lights I've tested that actually listed lumens that I'm looking at. They are, again, they're an amber. They are a flood, which means wide beam pattern, and as opposed to really, really far. I went ahead and put a quick disconnect with some heat shrinking on the connections last night, and kind of went from there. I did want to show you the box that they come in. Made me feel really, really warm and comfy after I started taking a look. These are all the different types they make. The new flood amber are the ones that I end up buying. But on the top of it, safer driving, better life. Winning, better life. Then everybody's probably thinking, well, great, it's on the roof rack. How do you get the power up there? Well, went ahead and put together last night a quick wiring harness with the plugs on the other side. And I do this just in case any of them have to be replaced or I decide I'm going a different direction. Instead of having to cut and rewire everything, you literally just plug and play each of these. So I have one here, what's called a T-tap. And what this does is kind of bite into the wire without having to, again, create a totally separate connection for it with some heat shrinking on it and then the plugs going on down the line. As far as length, it isn't guessed. My rack is 43 inches wide. All I did was take that divided by four, and it's just shy of 11 inches in between each light is how I'm gonna mount them. So that's how I space these guys out. Next, how am I supposed to get the power up there, right? Well, knew I definitely did not want to drill into the roof for a number of reasons. KC actually makes this really cool product, Universal Wire Hider. And everybody will talk about, there's a few videos out there talking about how it makes for a very clean installation. If you see my ride, I don't really care about the look so much as a clean installation. Mine is definitely more function. And I wanted to make sure that when off-roading, going through branches, limbs, whatever it happens to be, I didn't want exposed wire up there being ripped off by the first limb on the trail, rendering all my power on the roof rack useless. So I needed a way to hide it without drilling into my roof. That's definitely something I did not want to take on. I have figured out with a number of things that if water can find a way in, it will. So I wanted to eliminate that if I could. So with the KC product, it comes with this little, just over 3 feet long. It's fairly soft, very pliable rubber. You literally just open this guy up, stuff your wires in there, close it back on there, and then everything is nice and protected from basically your hood all the way up to your rack, which mine fits really, really well. You actually just affix this with some 3M tape that they provide. Directly to your windshield, your body, wherever you have a smooth surface to get it up to where you want to run it. And then that takes care of that. So Let me show you where I'm going to be putting it at. First thing before you just go slapping it on there is you want to take a look at everything else surrounding. So this is the driver's side of the vehicle, obviously. They say, or most people will show you to run it on the windshield all the way up, and then you can get to your rack that way. I did figure out the width of the wire hider is the same as this little piece on my A-pillar outside of the door. So if I wanted to, I could literally mount here and then go all the way up outside of the rain channel from the door to get to where I'm gonna mount the lights, which is gonna be on this piece all the way across. So looking at it here, is it best gonna be for the driver or the passenger? Passenger side initially is what I was thinking because I've already got the snorkel on this side. And since it already looked busy, I figured that was gonna be a good way to go. However, before I started cleaning it up and doing that, I noticed how close the windshield wiper comes to the edge. I mean, literally my pinky will not even fit in between there. So this is the return side of the windshield wiper. And honestly, there's not gonna be enough room for me to do it. So works out for the driver's side, which is where the install is gonna be because my battery's on the driver's side, my fuse panel's on this side, on the driver's side as well. So it's gonna make it a little bit easier for the length of wire I have to run. So ultimately I am gonna go with the driver's side for putting everything in. Stick with me and I will be right back to show you what I did. Something else I did want to mention, when you are cleaning your windshield or whatever else it's gonna be, to actually mount your adhesive strips to the back of the wire hider. Obviously these are chemicals and sticky and all that kind of good stuff too. Funny enough, some of the cleaners that you may be using have ammonia and some other chemicals in it that will actually break down the adhesive on this. So if you are gonna use a glass cleaner or something like that, make sure it lists somewhere on there, ammonia free, otherwise you will not be doing yourself a favor. And the sticky will be lost in a very short amount of time. You will be pulling this off and redoing everything to add some more 3M tape. So keep that in mind. All right, step one is gonna be prepping the glass area where you're gonna apply. Started peeling tape back here as well. And what I did was put the 3M tape all the way up to where the window was gonna end because I knew I was gonna install the rest of the product on the top on the paint. Again, because I wanted as much wire protection as I could possibly get. So I took this all the way down along the side, just outside of the rain gutter, to the back side of the mount so that when my wires come out, they'll just make a left and they're under the protection of the rack. Okay, what I'm gonna do now is take the wiring harness that I made last night, again, kind of work backwards, feed it through underneath the rack to the appropriate spot, and then gonna unroll the rest of this to see how much length we need. Okay, next up for me was running the wiring harness that I made last night. Again, sort of did this backwards. Just measured the width and then how I was gonna space the lights out, and that's how I determined where to put these T-taps at. So ran that all the way around, down, right past. You can see aux beam fuse panel. This is where I'm gonna put it, actually in the number one spot. And then ran a couple of feet past with the wire, and I'm gonna cut it here. Again, it's always good to have extra so you don't have to come back. The old saying, measure twice, cut once. Yeah. Okay, now that the wiring is cut, all I'm gonna do is feed it down through the inside of the actual protector, down and into the engine bay, and then we'll worry about our connections once we get our light. Just see right there, MH stands for Matterhorn. It's a Matterhorn rack, which is what they put on their third gen. Actually bought their mounts for the tracks and then put together everything else from a couple of online material resource places. But same style, little crossbars that they use. And one cool thing about doing that is you get to use these little pieces right here. And what these guys do is fit right down inside the tracks. It's got a little threaded part inside to where you literally flip these guys upside down, and then whatever you're gonna end up mounting, you just thread your bolt into it. So in this case, we're actually going to take the mounts for the lights, put these right on top of here, and then literally run the bolts through them, and it is literally. And the last and probably most critical part of this journey is the test before you clean all the wiring up. All right, here we are for the fun part, the actual testing outdoors. So I installed the Laser Gun 400s a couple of weeks ago, and here they are. As you can see, a true spot straight ahead. And then we have
all of the lights I just installed on the rack, and this will be the first time I've lit them up outside. So here, wow. Holy smokes. That is bright, folks. There is no other light out here but me. You can see at the very back there, kind of a safety light that's right by the lake. But this is, holy, I cannot. That is unbelievable. Yes, well worth it. Holy smokes.